Hey guys, Curtis Alexander. In this video, let's talk about the side effects that you can potentially see when you use minoxidil. And that could be either topically or orally, as well as let's talk about some things that can help you minimize those side effects. So first of all, let's talk a little bit about what minoxidil is doing in your body. It's important. It will help you understand the side effects. So first of all, it's a vasodilator, which means your blood vessels will dilate. Interestingly, Rogaine was originally developed as a blood pressure medication, but they found that when they gave it to these people, they started growing more hair. It also extends the growth phase or the anagen phase of your actual hair follicle, and it does increase as vasodilator. It's going to increase blood flow to the hair follicles. So there's a lot of good things that it could potentially do for hair growth. However, it comes with obviously some side effects. Keep in mind, the percentages I have listed here are their estimates. That doesn't mean it's going to happen. It's just trying to give you a ballpark of what to look for. So the first one, a fairly common one, is scalp irritation at 10%. When you first start applying it, it's probably going to be the worst, and it should get better as time goes along. Hair shedding, this is an important one. This is like a really ironic side effect. You apply this to grow hair and you shed more hair. However, this is very much in the beginning. Kind of mentally prepare yourself that this may occur the first 2 to 3 weeks and then should get better. Roughly 10% of people might experience this. So again, a lot of people won't. Interestingly, women can experience growth of very fine hairs on their face. Particularly, even if they're applying it topically, if you get some down below the scalp area, you can see growth of very fine hairs. They're usually not very noticeable, but we have roughly 5% of women who could run into that issue. Dizziness, lightheadedness, this makes sense because, again, we're dilating blood vessels. Even topically, people have reported this as a potential side effect. But again, we're getting a little lower, roughly 4%. Dryness and flaking of the scalp at 4%. Now we're going to start getting into ones that are rare, but they're worth mentioning. First one being allergic reaction. This can occur, obviously, any medication, any supplement. People can have allergic reactions. We'll talk about how to minimize that here in a second. We have chest pain, palpitations, again, very rare. But because of those vasodilation actions in your body, you know, we can run into some heart problems. I want to mention headache because it lists it as rare, but particularly when people apply it, if you have a history of migraines or headaches, something like minoxidil can make it worse applying it that way. So just keep that in mind. If you're seeing a neurologist, let them know you're using it. Edema, you know, that fluid retention that you can get, again, rare, but can happen. Finally, I would be on the lookout for an increase in heart rate or even an irregular heart rate. And yes, it could potentially happen even with topical or the applied minoxidil. So are there any things you can do to minimize the risks? There are. First of all, you want to set your expectations, particularly with something like the hair shedding. It's important that you know it can happen right out of the gate. Not to be shocked by it, and that should go away after some time, again, 2 to 3 weeks. You may need to lower the strength, either of if you're taking it orally, or most likely you're going to be using it topically. There are various strengths you may need to bump down to something lower. And particularly like the allergen thing, I always encourage people, do a patch test, meaning don't apply it on your whole scalp the first time. Just apply it on a small area, see how you react to it, make sure you don't have any issues, and if all is good, then you can go to a larger area. So, and don't forget, guys, I'm going to put a link in the description. Make sure to go to my website, get your free checklist. I talk about stuff like this and natural ways to tackle stuff like this a lot more on my email list, and I give you a free checklist of other natural therapies I personally use and recommend. So make sure to go grab that. Links in the description. I will see you in the next one, guys. Thank you.